Hey everybody, and welcome back to the last tutorial for the Let's Make a Farming Game series. So let's start by making some seed spawners. Go to the blueprint folder and make a new blueprint class of type actor. Rename it BP Wheat Seed. Under components, add a static mesh and rename it Seed. Under static mesh, search for the wheat seed mesh we made. Under physics, set the simulate physics to true. Then, under components, add a box collision and change the size so it's still a bit bigger than the seed mesh. When scrolling down and click on the on component, begin overlap event. From the execution pin, search for the cast to third person character. Connect the other actor to the object. From the as third person character, get the amount of wheat seed and add an increment integer to it. Connect the execution pins. From the increment integer, add a set amount of wheat seed and connect the integer pins. After that, use a destroy actor. Go back to the blueprint folder and duplicate the wheat seed and rename it BP Corn Seed. Go to the viewport and change the static mesh to the corn seed mesh we made earlier. Adjust the box collision so it sits around the mesh. In the event graph, delete the wheat seed variable and search for the get amount of corn seed. And after the increment integer, add the set amount of corn seed and connect the execution pins. Go back again to the blueprint folder and duplicate the corn seed blueprint. Rename it to BP Pumpkin Seed. Go to the viewport and change the static mesh to the pumpkin seed mesh we made earlier. In the event graph, delete the corn variable and add a get amount of pumpkin seed. After the increment integer, add a set amount of pumpkin seed. Now place the seeds in the world and see if they have correct physics and we walk over them if they get destroyed. They are working as intended, so let's delete these seeds since we will make spawners for the seeds. In the blueprint folder, make a new blueprint class of type actor and rename it BP Wheat Spawner. In the viewport, add a new component called billboard. Switch to the event graph. From the event begin play, add a spawn actor and search for the BP Wheat Seed. Drag a reference of the billboard component and search for the get world location. Then split the struct pin of the spawn actor and connect the location pins. Then add a random float in range and change the max to 360. Split the rotation pin and connect the random float to the X, Y and Z. This will make our seed spawn with a random rotation. After the spawn node, add a delay node and set it to 1 second. Then we will quickly switch to the BP Wheat Seed blueprint, since I forgot to add a lifespan to the seed. This will make it that after a certain amount of time our seeds get destroyed. In the viewport, click on the BP Wheat Seed and change the initial lifespan to 15. Also adjust this for the corn seed and the pumpkin seed. Alright, go back to the wheat spawner blueprint and connect the delay to the input of the spawn actor. So every second one seed will be spawned and deleted after 15 seconds. Now just duplicate the spawner. Rename it to BP Corn Spawner and change the spawn actor to BP Corn Seed. And lastly, repeat these steps for the pumpkin spawner. Now, let's go ahead and place our spawners in the world and test if they work. Okay, the seeds are falling as intended, and if you look closely, we can also see that some seeds are destroyed after 15 seconds. We can walk to the seeds and pick them up. And if you look in the left top corner, we see that the UI is updating with how many seeds we picked up. We can go ahead and plant some of the seeds. However, amount of seeds that we have are not taken into account, so we will go ahead and fix that. Let's start by closing some of the windows that we don't need and open up the BP farm tile. Add a new macro and name it Do We Have Wheat Seed. Then we want to add an execution pin for the input and output. And I also call them input and output. From the input, cast the third person character, and for the object use the get player character. Then add a branch to the execution pin, and to the false pin add a decrement integer. From the as third person character, add a get amount of wheat seed, and from there add a lower or equal to 0 and connect it to the branch. Also connect the variable to the input of the decrement node. Then from the as third person character, get a set amount of wheat seed and connect the decrement node to it. Connect the execution pin to the output. Duplicate the macro and rename it to Do We Have Corn Seed, and change the wheat variables to the corn variables. Lastly, duplicate it once more for the Do We Have Pumpkin Seed, and also adjust the variables there. Switch back to the event graph and drag the three macros into the event graph. Place the macros between the switch on integer and before the plant wheat, plant corn or plant pumpkin events. Now compile and save and see if the macros work. So pick up a couple of wheat seeds and plant them on the farm tile. As you can see, the seeds are now subtracted in the UI, and when we have 0 seeds, we cannot plant any more wheat plants. Now I would like to implement a simple mechanic to have a chance of your crop getting diseased. For this, I start by making a new material and rename it m_disease. Drag in a constant factor 3 and make it dark gray. Also drag in a constant and set it to 0.8 and connect it to the roughness. Now save the material and switch to the BP farm tile. Add a new macro to it and call it Chance of Disease. For the input, add an execution pin and call it Input. For the output, add an execution pin and call it No Disease. Also add a second input and set it to Static Mesh Component. and then a object reference. I rename this to static mesh component. From the input execution pin, add a branch node, and then from the boolean, search for an integer lower than integer node. Then add a random integer in range. Change the minimum to 1 and the maximum to 100. For the other node, I will set it temporarily to 50 to get a 50% chance of getting a deceased crop. Then connect the false pin of the branch to the output. If the branch is true, we want to set the boolean to fully grown to true and set the current mesh to the static mesh component input. Then grab the text3D and search for setText and set the value to the variable value, which is 0. Add a for loop and set the last index to 2. Then from the loop body add a setMaterial node. Connect the current mesh to the target and connect the index to the element index. Then set the material to the m_deceased_material. Also connect the completed execution pin to the material node. Compile and save. And make some room in our plant weed event. After the grow time has completed, we want to check if we should get a disease or not. So place it after the grow time node and before the destroy component. Also add this macro to the second and third growth stage. Compile and save this and let's see if it works. Pick up some weed seeds and plant them. As you can see, we have a couple weed crops that have a disease and some that manage to grow successfully. When harvesting the crop, the diseased crops don't give anything, but the fully grown weed crops give a harvested item. So, the last thing that can be added relatively quick is our two remaining crops. Let's add the corn and the pumpkins to complete this tutorial. Switch back to the farm tile where we already have the plant corn and plant pumpkin event. Now simply duplicate all the nodes we made for the plant wheat event and connect it to the plant corn event. Click on the add static mesh components and change it into the corn static meshes. And select the three models we made earlier. At the end, change the what can be harvested string to corn. Also replace the wheat grow time with the corn grow time. Also make sure that corn grow time is set to 15 seconds. Duplicate once more all the nodes and change the settings to the pumpkins. Compile and save and see if we are able to plant all of our crops. As you can see, we now have a working UI, we can pick up seeds, plant them. The crops have their own growth time, and in the end, we can harvest them. However, the chance of disease is too high for me. So, go back to the BP farm tile and open up the macro for the disease. Set the integer lower than integer to 1 and change the minimum for the random integer in range to 0. This should give us a 1% of getting a diseased crop. Now this concludes the Let's Making a Farming Game series. I will show you some gameplay of what we have made in this series. I hope you learned something useful for your game development. And I hope you like this series. If you have not done already, please consider subscribing to the channel. It really helps me out and gives me motivation to continue making more videos. I am still not sure on how to proceed with future videos. I might try something different for the next video. However, if you have some suggestions or questions about the previous videos, you can always join the Discord to talk to me there. The link can be found in the descriptions below the video.